Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be in this day today, and I am rejoicing. How about you? Let us hear from Reverend Ella McDonald in prayer.
Let us pray. Father God, as again we come, we thank you for this day. For this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
We thank you for grace and mercy
thank
this morning.
God.
We thank you for your son, Jesus, who gave his life on Calvary Cross for our salvation. Mm-hmm. And Lord, we thank you for being saved today.
Thank you,
Lord, God. We thank you for all the things that you have done for us, mm-hmm. because we know that if you had not been in our taking care of us, Lord, we wouldn't be here today. Father, we just come and say thank you again. Father, we thank you for all the things that you're doing in our life, how you're blessing
you,
us, how you're taking
you,
care of us, God, how you have blessed us to come into another year. We thank mm-hmm. you for that, Lord. Mm-hmm. We thank you for all the things that you've done. Lord, we ask you to touch this broadcast in a special way today, Lord,
thank
that
you,
it
Lord.
Might go out and somebody might hear a word from you, and they may turn their lives over to you. Lord, we thank you for what you're doing. Father, we ask you to continue to bless Grace Cup, oh God, as it go forth over the airway. Lord, we ask you to touch those that are sick and afflicted in our body today. Touch those in the hospital and convalescent home, Lord, behind prison wall, Lord, in the jail cell, Lord, wherever they are today, Lord. Touch them, oh God, that they would have a change of heart, and if they're not saved, and turn their lives over to you.
Lord,
we thank you for what you're doing on this program. Father, because we know without this program, somebody might not hear a word from you. So we thank you, oh God, for what you're doing. Now, Lord, we ask you to continue to heal, bless, and deliver, and set free. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, and thank God.
In Jesus'
Hallelujah.
Name, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And today, we would like to say hello to Sister Twyla Johnson.
Amen.
She said she's always watching the program, and she is certainly blessed. So we thank God for you, Sister Twyla.
Amen.
Keep watching. God Amen. Bless you. Now let's turn the scripture, St. John 15, 7 through 17. St. John 15, beginning at 7. And it reads, "If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you." That's
Thank
good
you,
word,
Lord.
Isn't it?
Thank you, Lord.
"Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit, mm-hmm. so shall ye be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue mm-hmm. ye in my love. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love.
Yes.
Even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love.
Mm-hmm.
These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full.
Yes.
This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends."
Yes, yes.
"Ye are my friends."
Yes, hallelujah.
"Ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you.
Mm-hmm.
Henceforth, I call you not servants, but the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, that I have made known unto you."
Thank you, Lord.
"Ye have
yes.
not chosen me,
mm-hmm.
but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye should go and bring forth fruit,
mm-hmm.
and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye ask of the Father in my name, he shall give it to you."
Mm-hmm.
That's a good one right there.
Amen. Amen.
"These things I command you, that ye love one another."
Yes.
Love one
yes.
another. Isn't it wonderful to know
Hallelujah.
That Jesus is our friend?
Amen.
He is our friend. And he says, whatsoever ye ask, it's yours.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful, Jesus. Now let us hear from Bettina Turner. What a friend we have in Jesus. Sister Bettina, what a friend we have in Jesus. Amen. What a friend we have in Jesus. He's our friend. And now let's hear the word of God from the Reverend Ella McDonald, Kingdom Building Ministries. God bless you.
Good afternoon. As we pray, pray with us today. Father God, we come in the name of Jesus. How we love you, how we bless you today. Father God, we ask you as your word go out today, Lord. Give someone an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying. Oh God, touch our hearts, Lord, that we might speak your divine truth. God, we give you praise and we give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And today we're going to come from Ephesians, the fourth chapter, beginning at the 26th verse. And then we're going to skip over to the 30th verse and go from there. And it reads as following. It said, be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. And then 27 said, neither give place to the devil. And then we're going to skip over to the 30th verse. It said, grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger, clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. And today we're going to speak on the believers to walk, putting off the garment of the old man. And we're going to speak on anger today. And because we know when you're walking in anger, you still have on the garment of the old man. And it goes say that anger, the believer is to strip away the garment of anger. Men do become angry, but the scripture recognizes this and said there is time when anger is called for. But we are to guard against sin and when we become angry. Anger causes us to act or react, lash out, hurt others, or else it motivates us to right, wrong, and correct injustice. And as I was in my daily prayer this morning, even last week, I began to think about the word anger. And when we look around in our community, in our school, in our children, in our adults, we see anger. We see so much anger in the world. Even in our young children, we see anger. But the Word of God speaks about anger. Number one, there's a wrong anger of what may be called unjustified or selfish anger. And then I like to go on and say, even though when you're walking in anger, you're outside of the Spirit of God. And I have said to myself this year, and I want you to say it to yourself this year, I will not walk in anger. I will not walk in anger. Because when you're walking in anger, you cannot walk in the Spirit. So we're going to put away anger this year, aren't we? And number A, there's the anger that brood, that it is selfish. It's a selfish anger. It harbors malice. It will not forget. It lingers. It broods. It will revenge and sometimes seeks revenge. Number two, there's the anger that holds contempt. It despises, it ridicules, it arrogantly exalts itself and calls another person empty and useless. This is an anger that is full of malice. It despises and scorns. It arises from pride, a pride wrath. Peter 21:24, such anger, feeling of anger, walk over and trample a person. It say that whatever ill come upon a person deserves it. That is the anger that curses. It seeks to destroy a man and his reputation, morally, intellectual, and spiritual. Now, we do not want to walk in that type of anger. An anger that just trample on a person. An anger that brings a person down. And even when you read in the book of Ephesians, it tells us how to treat our children. It tells us not to provoke our children to anger. And you know, as parents, sometimes we can even provoke our children to anger. And then they grow up to be angry children. So we need to know how to talk to our children, know how to love them, know how to treat them so they will not grow up with an angry spirit. And as parents, we need to pray for our children. We need to bring them before God when we see anger in our children and ask God to help us
to lead and guide that child in the right direction. But first, as parents, we need to go before God ourselves and ask God to search our hearts. And if there's anger, if there's malice, or any of these things in our heart, we need to ask God to move those things out of our heart. Because such as that child see, if he see the parents' anger, and in anger, then he grows up in anger. He or she grows up in anger also. So those are some of the things that we do not want to take into this year, an angry spirit, unless there is a right spirit. Now, there is a right spirit. There's a right anger of what may be called justified anger. The believer must be angry, maybe an angry person, angry with those who sin and do wrong and who are unjust and selfish in their behavior. Now, the Word of God says there is a righteous anger. When you're seeing somebody being treated wrong or that injustice being done, then that is a right anger. It says, is our way limited to those who do wrong, either against God or against others? The distinguished mark between justified and unjustified anger is that a justified anger is never selfish. It's never selfish. It is being shown because of what had happened to oneself. It is an anger that is purposeful. The believer knows that he is angry for a legitimate reason, and he seeks to correct the situation in a most peaceful way. So when we find out there is an anger, or we're walking in anger, we should find out a peaceful way to get rid of this anger. And the only peaceful way that we can find to get rid of our anger is to come before God. Come before God and ask God to move that anger out of our spirit. And another thing that will bring anger into a person's heart. So what is a worthless talk? The believer is to strip away filth and foul talk. The word corrupt means rotten, foul, purified, and polluted. Corrupt talk, of course. An unholy talk and even the worthless conversation that is so often carried on by peoples. Now, when we get in the middle of these conversations, their corrupt conversation, their worthless conversation, and even our children get into these conversations in school. And then before they know it, then there's anger that builds up in them. They want to fight somebody. They want to curse somebody. And then they find themselves in a lot of trouble. So the way we should get rid of this anger as parents, we need to teach our children the right anger and the wrong type of anger. And these are some of the things that we want to talk about today. Parents, we need to teach our children not to walk in anger. The believer to speak only that which is good and that would edify and build up peoples. Speeches for the purpose of sharing good things, of building up and strengthening people, ministering grace, favor, and blessing, and helping each other as we plow through life. Isaiah 50:4 say, the Lord had given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak a word in season to him that is weary. He wakens morning by morning. He wakens my ear to hear of the learned. So we have to learn how to not be angry. We have to learn how to walk in love. We have to learn how to walk in peace and the peace of God. Then they that fear the Lord spake often one to another, and the Lord hearkened and heard it, and the book of remembrance were written before him for them that fear the Lord, and that they thought upon his name, which is taken from Malachi 3:16. And then we must ask the Holy Spirit to come into our hearts. The believer is to strip away the garment of being contrary or grieving the Holy Spirit. And you know, we have the Holy Spirit that lives on the inside of us, giving meaning to pain, to offend, to vex, or sadden the Holy Spirit. When a child acts contrary to the counsel of his parents, he hurts and grieves them. So when a person acts contrary to the counsel of the Holy Spirit, he hurts and grieves the Holy Spirit. So when we are walking in anger, when we're walking in malice, when we are walking in all those things, we are grieving the Holy Spirit. The command is forceful, very forceful. This is seen in the name of the Holy Spirit. He is not only called the Holy Spirit here, he is called both the Holy Spirit and the Spirit of God. And I like to say to you, when you have the Spirit of God dwelling inside of you, then you have this fruit of the Spirit on the inside of you. And I don't know about you, but I decide that I am going to walk in the Holy Spirit this year. No matter what goes on inside of my life, no matter what goes on, I am going to walk in the Holy Spirit. Well, then you might ask me, what is the fruit of the Spirit? Okay, if you go to Galatians 5 and 22, it said, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, and faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. When you walk in these, and when you walk in the Spirit, and they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with affection and the lust. So when you walk in the Holy Spirit, when you walk in the fruit of the Spirit, then you can walk out of anger, you can walk out of those corrupt things that you have done, and you because you have this fruit of the Spirit on the inside of you. What is the fruit of the Spirit? It is the fruit of love. What is the fruit of love? It is that agape love, the love of the mind. It is the love of the mind. Is it of the reason, of the will? Is it the love that goes so far? It is the love that regardless of feeling, whether a person feel like loving or not, what this fruit does is that whether I feel like loving you or not, I'm going to love you anyway because I choose not to be angry, because I choose not to be upset at you, because I choose whatever you've done to me that I can forgive you, because I can forgive you because of the agape love. What is the agape love? The agape love is the love of God. It is that love that Christ loved us so much that he gave his life for us so we can have that same love through the fruit, with this fruit of the Spirit that lives on the inside of us, which is the agape love. What is it? There's the love of a person, even if that person doesn't deserve to be loved. And sometimes you might meet a person that you think that does not need to be forgiven, that you should stay angry with that person, that you choose not to love him. But God said he loved you so much, why you were still nasty, messed up, and still in your sin, why you were still angry, why you were committing adultery, why you committing fornication, why you were cursing, acting ugly, acting nasty, he still sent his son Jesus, and he died on that cross for you so that you could change your life and that you could become that new creation in Christ. So if he did that for you, you can love that angry person. You can love him until he can come to himself and forgive him so that he's not angry anymore and you're not angry anymore. So one of the things we learned this year, that we are not going to walk in anger this year. We're not going to walk in selfishness this year. We're not going to walk in bitterness this year. But we are going to walk in the fruit of the Spirit this year. And it also goes on, said, ask your love the person who utterly unworthy of being loved. You have seen some people that you think, this person is not worthy of being loved. But God loves everyone. He loves everybody. Even if you're in your sin, I don't care what you've done today, God still loves you. He will not love the things that you've done. If they're unrighteous, if they're unholy, he does not love those things, but he still loves the person. And another fruit we're going to walk in this year is going to be the fruit of peace. We're going to walk in peace this year because the word of God said, without peace, no man shall see the Lord. So that means that if you are not living in peace, if you have not got the spirit of peace in your heart, you cannot see the Lord. So we're saying to you, you need to walk in peace this year. You need to walk in love this year. We need to walk in unforgiveness this year. And we need to walk out of selfishness this year and walk in the fruit of the Spirit. Selfishness, or the agape love, is the gift of God. And we can only love through the Spirit of God. And it said, now hope, abideth faith, hope, charity, these three. But the greater of these is charity. And when you put on charity, which is love, you can love your enemy. Even the person that hurt you, even the person that did you wrong last year, you can still walk out of your anger and say, I forgive you because God has forgiven me. So we're going to say today, if you had anger in your heart when this message started today, walk out of it. You can still love that person because God so loved you. Because John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And if you have not received Jesus Christ as your personal Savior today, you can say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me for my sin. I repent of my sin. Because the word of God says, if thou confess with thy heart, mouth and believe in thy heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, thou shall be saved. And if you repeat those words with me today, you are saved because you have given God first preference in your life. And he said, if you come to me, I will no wise turn your way. So today you are saved if you have confessed those words. And say with me, thank you, Jesus. I am saved. Amen. All I can say is,